Hi guys, it's Dan O'Donnell from PositiveAtmosphere.com, and I was actually just about to go to bed. It's about 2 in the morning, but I came across an article about a book that came out recently called Bright Sided, and it's by Barbara Ehrenreich. The premise of the book is that positive thinking played a large part in things like the financial crisis. Actually, I wish I wouldn't even said that. The financial situation that, you know, the United States and the world is in. The statement that she'll give here in a second, I'll play you the clip, is that delusion is always bad. And I actually went and saw this author talk down in Seattle a few weeks ago. Decided not to do a video about it at the time, because in general, I don't really want to, I'm not here to be against anything, really. But I think, you know, what is done, at least in what I've seen with her discussing this book and positive thinking and the culture around it, is that it seems like it's a very broad blanket statement about positive thinking. And she says things like, you know, delusion is always bad, and she calls it magical thinking. And I would agree that, you know, delusion is not good. I would disagree that positive thinking is delusion. I think that trying to sum up positive thinking is kind of like trying to sum up religion, or, you know, saying religion is bad, or eating is bad. You know, eating too much and eating the wrong things can be very bad. That doesn't make eating bad. You know, there are some forms of positive thinking out there that don't serve people because they're not founded in any kind of evidence or reality, and that can mislead people and can get hopes up, and if it's not practical, that can lead to disappointment. And so anyway, I'm going to play this clip here. I'm going to use my advanced video editing technique here, so get ready. This is Barbara Ehrenreich, the author of Bright Sided.
I'll take a hard line here. Delusion is always dangerous. And the big example I would give of that is the 08 financial meltdown. There are many things that fed into that. I'm not going obviously into a whole analysis of the economics and the different weird exotic financial instruments and so on. But, you know, many, many people got way over their heads in debt. Ordinary people. And in what frame of mind do you assume large amounts of debt? Well, a positive frame of mind. You think that you're not going to get sick, your car's not going to break down, you're not going to lose your job, and you're going to be able to pay it off. And if your pastor is in addition saying, as Joel Osteen has said many times, God wants you to have a larger house, and you know, could never before qualify for a mortgage, and somebody comes along and says, boy, do I have the mortgage for you. It seems like God has reached down to help you with that. Mostly, though, I blame the top levels of a corporate culture, which by the middle of this decade was completely in a bubble of mandatory optimism and positive thinking. Countrywide mortgage, for example, which arguably, you know, set off the whole subprime crisis, has been described by a former vice president as having a cult-like atmosphere. A culture of high fives and woo-woos, or whatever. I can't do that noise right, you know, the woo sound.
Okay, guys, so it sounds like there are a couple examples of delusional thinking, countrywide being one of them, that were a complete disaster, right? And I won't argue that. I'm sure she's done a lot of great research and probably has a good point with that. But what I would counter with is there are some pretty significant examples of when positive thinking helped the world, the United States, the economy, all of this, both in government and in the corporate world also. One big example would be John F. Kennedy standing up and saying, hey, by the end of the decade, we're going to put a man on the moon. Okay, he did not stand up and say, by the end of tomorrow afternoon, we're going to put a man on the moon, even though we don't have any clue how we're going to do that, and we couldn't even, you know, build the launch pad for the rocket that quickly. He said, hey, we're going to give it a decade, and even that seemed like a tight deadline to people, but they made it happen. He set a clear vision, a clear goal with a deadline, and they worked towards it. The key being worked towards it, right? Another one would be Henry Ford. He said he wanted to make a V8. All his engineers told him he was nuts. You know, that's never going to happen. And they failed over and over and over again, thinking that he might eventually give up. He didn't. He said, go back, you know, try again, do it differently, try again, try again, try again. And they made the V8 happen. And again, he didn't just say, well, let's all go take a nap, or, you know, we'll go on vacation, and we'll let the intern do it, and we'll come back and we'll have a V8. No, no, no. You know, they worked their butts off, and he put all his best guys on that project. So I guess the reason I'm doing this video is because a lot of people right now see videos and read books like this here, like Bright-Sided, and they say, oh, well, I was thinking about trying positive thinking, but since this book tells me that it doesn't work, I won't waste my time, and I'll just continue to be a victim. So I think this book in some ways could be dangerous, because it can give people the idea that it's not worth trying and that positive thinking is just some kind of a joke. It's not. All the top achievers out there employ some form of positive thinking. If you don't believe that you can make something happen, you'll never try it. So I just wanted to address that. Haven't read the book yet, I'll admit that, but have seen these videos and went to the book talk. And that's my take on it. That's my two cents. So if you're into positive thinking, go check out positiveatmosphere.com. It's a cool site with a bunch of videos and blogs and great people there sharing how they use positive thinking to improve their lives. So positiveatmosphere.com. Thank you for watching.